Boxing is a brutal sport. It has the highest highs and the lowest lows. Getting knocked out can end a fighter's career right then and there. A split-second mistake could change a boxer forever. So, without further ado, let's take a look at the most brutal boxing knockouts of all time. Buster Douglas shook up the boxing world when he knocked out Iron Mike Tyson in one of the biggest upsets in sports ever. The 42-1 underdog was expected to get demolished by Tyson, who was undefeated at the time and seemed unbeatable. Buster's mom passed away in the lead-up to the fight, which stirred up a monster inside the boxer. Douglas had the training camp of a lifetime and came in tremendous shape. On the other hand, Mike had an infamously terrible training camp. Drugs, women, food, Mike was engulfed by his vices. Besides showing up overweight to camp, he, like everyone, thought he would bulldoze through his opponent with ease. Many were debating how many seconds Douglas would last, so the world was shocked when Buster made it past the first round. He made it to the 10th round and blasted Mike with a flurry of punches, dropping him for the first time. A dazed Tyson couldn't make the 10 count. His aura of invincibility was shattered. Buster would be unable to capture the same magic he did during the Tyson fight. He would go on to lose against Evander Holyfield in his first defense of the title. The great Manny Pacquiao delivered one of the most impressive performances against the British Ricky Hatton. Pacquiao's speed advantage was clear from the very first round, getting the best of him in most exchanges. Hatton slipped back to his old ways, abandoning the game plan and getting careless with his defense. The Philippine native capitalized on the opportunity and landed a picture-perfect left hand on the Brit, knocking him stiff and forcing him into early retirement. Manny continued his legendary run in boxing and retired in 2021 after losing to your Dennis Ugas. Hatton would return 3.5 years later to lose by TKO against Vyacheslav Sinchenko and retired for good. Pacquiao's win is more impressive because he jumped up a few weight classes for this fight, and Ricky was clearly the bigger man. The four kings of boxing, Roberto Duran, Sugar Ray Leonard, Marvin Hagler, and Thomas Hearns, formed the pantheon of the boxing greats during the late 1970s and early 1980s. Duran's showdown with Detroit's own Tommy the Hitman Hearns was an absolute barn burner for as long as it lasted. Hearns demolished Duran in 2 rounds, following a flurry of punches. The American landed a vicious right hand on the mark, knocking Roberto out cold for the first time in his career. Julian the Hawk Jackson, arguably the hardest puncher in the history of boxing, and he could generate show-stopping power out of thin air. A perfect example of this is in his bout against Herol. Graham was schooling Jackson throughout the fight, but the Hawk pulled out a Hail Mary, landing a missile for right hook and ending the fight in a mesmerizing fashion. The year is 2004. Roy Jones Jr. is the sports pound-for-pound king. Having only suffered one defeat by disqualification and had dominated the light heavyweight division for years. But Tarver gave him fits in their first contest, something Jones attributed to having to lose weight for a successful attempt at the heavyweight title. The rematch didn't last nearly as long, but was just as shocking. For a fighter who had rarely been challenged and never hurt, Jones ate a stunning left hand that sent him down and out for the first time, flipping the boxing world on his head. It was his first, but not last, legitimate loss. Mike Tyson makes the next entry on the list. This time, he's the one delivering the knockout punch. After capturing the heavyweight title, Michael Spinks was on a collision course with the undefeated Mike Tyson. The only way to describe Tyson in his prime was perfectly violent. He threw every punch with malicious intent. His defense was perfect. Movement immaculate. Everything was flawless. At the time, many saw Spinks as the only person to be able to beat Tyson. Oh, how wrong they were. In typical fashion, Tyson blitzed Spinks and bulldozed right through him. It only took him 91 seconds. Scary stuff. Britain's Lennox Lewis is undoubtedly one of the greatest heavyweights of all time. As a technician, he stood out from the brutes and had possessed unusually swift hands. His upset loss of Rahman was a shock to many. On paper, Lennox was the better fighter in every way. Lewis first won a battle in Cork to obtain his immediate rematch against Rahman, as Rahman tried to land another opponent for his first title defense. Lewis defended his title twice after beating Rahman, calling it a career, and beating Mike Tyson and Vitaly Klitschko by KO victory. Ray Mercer handed Tommy Morrison his first loss after a vicious barrage of punches knocked him out dramatically on October 18th of 1991. Both fighters came into the fight with undefeated records, and Mercer, 17-0, was fresh off his victory with Francesco Damiani, giving him the WBO heavyweight title, whilst Morrison was rocking a 28-win fight streak. Mercer was the better boxer and blew through the Duke with ease. Morrison soared to the top of the heavyweight division in 1993, but his downfall was just as quick as his rise to the top. Constant partying and drinking during and between camps led to his deterioration as a fighter. During their WBC heavyweight title fight, David Tua knocked out John Ruiz with thunderous blows. Tua came out to knock Ruiz out, and did so in lightning-quick fashion, ending the fight in 19 seconds. Tua caught Ruiz with a powerful left and then landed a series of punches, knocking Ruiz out. Adding insult to injury, as Ruiz fell to the canvas, Tua caught Ruiz with a ripping left hand, further banishing Ruiz into the shadow realm. Rocky Marciano's historic one-punch knockout of Jersey Joe Walcott is without debate the most brutal boxing knockout of all time. Walcott dismissed Marciano as any threat, telling all who would listen how this young kid could not give him a tough battle, let alone defeat him. Rocky was an inexperienced brute, lacking finesse and technique in the veteran's eyes. Walcott infamously told reporters, "He can't fight. If I don't lick him, take my name out of the record books." It's true. Rocky was the clumsier, more awkward, and undersized boxer going into the fight. But one thing he did have was heart. No matter how many punches he ate, his pride never allowed him to give up. The war went as expected. Jersey Joe was the better boxer, and he was en route to a unanimous decision win. But Rocky had more grit. He never slowed down and kept the pace up. In the 13th round, Rocky, battered and bruised with his left eye swollen shut, landed a nuclear right hook followed by a vicious left hand. Walcott collapsed with his left arm still hanging over the ropes, where he was counted out. The two were set for an immediate rematch. Many expected a similar fight to the first, but the crowd was disappointed to see Jersey Joe knocked out in the opening round, leaving him no choice but to retire from the sport of boxing. Rocky Marciano remains the only heavyweight champion to end his career undefeated with a legendary record of 49-0 with 43 knockouts. If you enjoyed this, make sure to show us some love by leaving a like and subscribing to our channel. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.